After the Dark Lord fell, many in the magical world felt at a loss as to what to do. With no evil to avenge, and no threats to the Ministry of Magic to thwart, some in the community resorted to finding long-term employment in the Muggle world. None more so than the most well-known of all wizards, but since killing Voldemort quite frankly average, Harry Potter. So, instead of seeking the Magic Seeker's allowance from Gringotts, Harry retrained as a doctor. After getting a middle to good score on F-Pass, he found himself starting his foundation training at the Royal Sussex County Hospital. Little did Harry know that some of his prior tormentors had also retrained. Let's meet Harry as he meets the radiologists for the first time.
Hello, is anyone here? I need to request a scan.
Silence, boy!
Who is that? I can't see in here. It's really dark.
It is I!
Dr. Marchback?
No, not that eye! He's stabbing!
Professor Snape? Snape! I thought you were dead. In that case, if I could just quickly discuss the scan with you.
Shut up, Lord Chief! Yes, it is I, Soda Snape! Order of Merlin, first class, MBBS, grade 3 piano, and now, Fellowship of the Royal College of Radiology. I have returned!
Radiology, but... Why radiology? Surely it's beneath you.
Beneath me, boy! Do you want to be beneath me? Radiology combines two of my greatest passions, dark arts and dark rooms.
Okay, sir. Back to the scan, perhaps.
Potter wants a scan, does he? Let's hear this piece of dribble, boy.
So we need to request a CTPA for a patient that we think might have a PE. He's an 87-year-old gentleman who's become really, really breathless and has got pleuritic chest pain. He's really hypoxic. His chest x-ray is normal and his well score is 8.5.
Bravo, Harry Potter! You
never
cease to amaze me with how much of a dum-dum you really are! His well score 7!
But it is!
He's got a small chest! 10 points from Gryffindor!
What? About. That's back at my house.
A D-dimer?
A D-dimer? Well, no. His well score is high enough not to need one.
Oh! High enough not to need one? Are you high enough off your head, boy? Drinking 2 minute butter beers down the George?
That doesn't even exist.
He needs a D-dimer. Everyone needs one. It's got magical properties.
That may be so, but I'll be honest, it's not very specific.
Not very specific?
No.
Well, let me be specific, boy. I want a D-dimer.
What?
And I want the med reg to review your patient.
But why?
And ITU. And I want a coffee, and I want a cappuccino with lime in it, and I don't want it from WRVS. But let's face it, what does that really stand for? We're really very slow!
Thank you. this. My consultants are seeing him this morning, Mr. McFadden, you know?
Mr. McFadden.
Yes, yes.
The offer being accepted.
Yeah, you're the very good one, actually.
Might as well be seen by one of Sir Exo!
Please, sir, can I have the scan?
Hang on, boy.
Got you that coffee of yours, if you want it. Okay. I've done his D-dimers, and they are raised. If you don't believe me, here's an extra sample for you to check. Okay. I've spoken to the medical registrar and the IT registrar, and they think it's PE. And Dr. Please, Professor Stick, can I just have the scan, just this one, please?
Potter!
Oh, no, oh!
Potter!
Professor Stick!
I will never do your poxy scan!
That's an impression of control.
Bye!
It took me 30 minutes to write that, Professor Stick, and 5 seconds to copy it. Professor, please. Hold on, there's another consultant, hold on. Professor Dumbledore. Professor Dumbledore. I'm really sorry, I know this isn't your patient, but you know how slow this is.
No, no, no.
Yes. You know what?
Dumbledore!
I need this scan. Look, my